is an Ultegra 6810 direct mount. That outside nut that they used, it's not standard. You take two points out between each to make a 4-point wrench. That, get the first nut off. Now it takes this wrench, and any pair of needle nose will probably work. I'm just showing you what I'm trying to do. If you've got one of these that's very difficult to turn, that should be moving very easily, and it's not. This is plastic, this little ring here, and that is the bearing basket. If you can see that, there's a little groove in the center of one side, and the same thing here, a little groove flat on the other side, and that is the basket. So if you go prying or damaging this, you're going to damage the bearing. This is plastic here. Now we've got the nut, or both nuts, off of this one, and it takes a good bit of force to get it out. This one, you have the offset to deal with, and I used a little piece of wood to create the offset. A lot of the times the brake will scratch when you first put it together. If you take a file on this bracket here, where the adjuster screw is going in, if you take a file to that inside edge right there, that's what's actually scratching. And it doesn't take removing much, but that'll get your clearance up. That's an old outlet box. There, it just started to go. It isn't a tremendous amount of force that holds it. And if you can see, that's a lot of grit. And you can see through the side, and you will see bearings. There is no seal. There's nothing that's holding back any grit. That's the bearing race. On this side. You don't want to lose these ball bearings. They seem to start coming out as soon as this race is removed. Yep. Just like last time. That was the first pass just in the bore of this. But it's what you expect for a open bearing. That's all the critical stuff. And in order. You've got the through bolt, bearing race, basket with bearings, bearing race, arm, washer, hex nut, funky nut, and the same for the other arm. If your brake isn't working very well, you can take a second spring and try and attach it to the hole and stud there. So far, that lasted for one night, about 25 miles, with both of them in parallel, and it worked really well. It just takes a little bit more force to actuate the brake. I got the first one done. So, definitely couldn't turn that by hand before. Seems to be a pretty good setting. There's no play here. It spins pretty easily. That little collar on the basket is there to help retain that race. So this is the side that the bearings can come up. It appears as though that's how easy it is to get it back together. And the washer. I didn't put any grease on this either. I couldn't see any signs of grease. Shimano, the colored side, the side that has that little raised groove, is on the outside. Okay. A little bit tight for me. prototype. I think that'll do. So here we are the next day. And is it any better after a ride? Can't turn it by hand anymore. Barely. Barely. So that's interesting. This one is even more stiff. Bearing moves fine. And that's interesting. Next, the bolt does not. Bearing moves fine here too. 12 from Craftsman. 12. Stamped steel is probably going to work a little bit easier with a file. This is just a bit thinner than these, but I'm not sure. Let's test out how soft this is. Forget the other way. Yeah, that takes out a lot of material. That's definitely possible. Pick out which one of these you like. Start with, you got 1, 2. Take that one. We have 1, 2. Take that one. 1, 2. Take that one. So those are the ones that you want to just make sure you don't touch with a file. And I would color them through both sides so that you can see. You're probably going to also want to take a little bit of the face off of that, because it's got a taper so that the bolt slides in a little bit easier normally. You're going to want to get as much purchase as possible into that. So pardon the shaky hands, but there's the first pass, or the first notch taken out. Play the guinea pig here. Didn't spin well even after the first day. Decided to cut that plastic out. The one that I pointed out here. This plastic. Just a file just to make the face as smooth as possible. Razor blade. First, start cutting around here. That left a lot of mess, so I came back with a drill bit by hand. Just like that. Until it passed through. No power, just by hand. This says it's a 21 over 64, 8.33 millimeters. So after taking out all that material, there's a little bit more play, but the bolt definitely spins freely. Is that there is a little lip when the race goes into that. Looks like it was intended to locate the race. And the race is placed here. That's such a tight fit, it doesn't want to come out. Once it's been put together, absolutely no play in that. This is a brass washer that has been drilled out and as flat as I can get it. We've got the bore that has nothing in it. Try a little bit of grease because we're getting metal on metal contact. I'm still not greasing the bearing. Out that way. let's see how that compares. I'll get back to you tomorrow. So day three. So this is the side that doesn't have the brass nut on it. After riding last night, once again, can't turn it by hand. This is the side that has the brass nut, right there. Easy turn. Feels as smooth as it did yesterday. So I would say that's the way forward. That's the best solution. It's the brass nut. Already made another one. Let's get this thing apart. Proper 13 finally came in the mail. Seems like some kind of like PTFE or some kind of glued on like plastic. Not sure what they're using. There's a metal sleeve underneath it. As you can see, it doesn't come out very easily. The other one came out by cutting. This one seems to come out in one piece. More of one piece. Yeah, there you go, there's the film. Looking at the top surface here, it's starting to look like a little bit of corrosion. On the other one, there was definite signs of corrosion in this ring area. So I think this is a steel insert, by the looks of it. There's some other kind of insert right here in this area on this side. Doesn't have that same plastic coating on it. I think that's a bushing. I don't think I need the drill bit for this one. Through that side. Not through this side. Huh. So this one's gonna have a tighter bushing on it. And that's where the clearance. It's still tight. That's interesting. That seems pretty good. Put the steel washer on, then the brass, then the nut. The side with the collar goes away from the bolt head. So that feels pretty good. So let's see. So since I've exposed the metal here, and this has the corrosion where it was up against that side before, I'm putting them in together. If they corrode together, it still puts the brass surface against the smoother surface, and I'm hoping that those will create the interface that all friction is transmitted through. If you look inside this nut really carefully, it isn't threaded all the way through, so it actually has a stop. Be able to see it in there. That is smooth. Is it as smooth as this one? Yeah. That I like. Definitely, I can see using that. Alright, well, let's get them back to you there. So day four. think it's moving. It stays pretty well moving. But I think that bushing is getting a good bit of grip on it. So last night, if you look at the time on the computer, it shows that I was riding pretty late. So I went through some sprinklers, so this got wet. Not drenched, but a bit wet. That side still feels good. This side here. This one, it's not as good. I noticed watching the video from yesterday, I didn't put any grease in here. I did grease the bore at one point, but not the stack of washers. So let's see what that does. See if that changes anything. Collected some. I'm getting the signs of corrosion. That was the outside edge towards the nut. This is the inside edge, and it's pretty shiny. Huh. This is dirty. I can still remove that by hand. That's good. So that looks good, and it's still got just a thin film of grease on it. The sleeve portion of the bore, this side here, there's a split in the middle. There you can kind of see that there's two different surfaces in there. Let's try and be a little bit more generous with the grease this time. I'm afraid greasing these bearings is just going to cause them to collect more material, more grit and grime. That's why I haven't done it yet. It didn't have what appeared to be grease before. I think this side has a bushing too. It's just different than the other side, which is surprising to me. Looks like there's a seam here in the center where it looks like it's a bushing. The line that I'm seeing in the bushing is here, right where the back of my razor blade is. And the obvious seam for the sleeve is here. So they don't line up, so that has to be two separate pieces in there. So this does have a bushing separate from that sleeve. This edge, up to about a third of the way through, is the arm itself. It's going to be hard to show that on camera, but trust me, that's what it is. Trust somebody random on the internet you don't know. Come on, do it. At the bottom there, you should see the little white line. I think that is the seam for the bushing. This is the sleeve side that had the plastic that came over the outside, and that's 8.55. And these things aren't terribly accurate, so 8.5. This side, just over 9. I think we can get that stuff. 8.53. That's the bushing, I think. Of course, I've passed a drill through that. I didn't push this hard through at all, and there was no sign of metal or anything coming out either. I mean, it doesn't go through easily, it never has, but it's just like this, you know, there's a little bit of a pause and it's passing through. It doesn't take any effort, it just takes persistence, and I've never done anything more than that, just finger tight. So this didn't have
some kind of surface that I've removed by using this. Nothing substantial, at least. Let's measure this again. We're zero. This came up 8.33 before, and now we've got right about the same, 8.3. That should easily pass through here.
See you tomorrow. So, day five. This is straight off the bike. Haven't done anything to it. It spins perfectly fine, just like, what, 2 days ago? It spins great. Yeah, I'm not going to take this apart again. I think that's enough. I'm satisfied. If this video is still up, that means that this is still a working solution. If this for some reason fails dramatically, then I will remove the posting so you will not see this video. I'm going to try and see if I can modify this spring. So it is quite possible to modify these springs to make them effectively shorter. The leg here that sticks out is there to help it stop from spinning all the way around. So you have to twist it and move it around a little bit to get it to work. As you can see, I'm shortening the spring. So that's going to effectively cause it to increase its force. If you take it off, it is possible there's a tooth you'll see in the pictures right here. So as you can see, the tooth that's in there is holding the spring in the back. It is possible to pry it up and over and to remove the bracket. If you do that, when you go to put it back on, use some pliers like these to press it, and it'll go over the ramp. But yeah, that should do it. That's everything I know. Good luck.
Day six. So everything is a trade-off. Still feels really good. No problems there. You can see it's quite dirty. But the spring, by shortening it just that much, it changed the feel of the brakes quite a bit. I wouldn't do this unless I absolutely had to. The use of the extra spring felt better to me with a poorly functioning brake. So that's it. Let's see, while we're here, let's take a couple measurements. The side of the grooves is right at 12 millimeters. It's 14. Across the groove, 13.6. The bore diameter, right at the barrel of the bolt, 7.96. I don't know why it would be relevant to anyone, but this total stack is around 4.5. This washer is 0.5 millimeter thick. Outside diameter is 14 millimeters. Inside the diameter is around 9 millimeters. A little over 9 millimeters. The lip, 7.8. This bore diameter, 6.2. Race, 1 millimeter thick, 14.8 millimeters, inside diameter is 10 millimeters. 28.5, 13.5, 10 steps, 9.92 on here, 13.5
total outside diameter, 9.8 on the notches,
42.83 total length of the inner bolt. The head has custom steps in it, that's where it's getting its retainer key. That's around 3.5, 9. This was using these are 12.9, these are actually half inch outer diameter, and they're drilled out with the 21/64, slightly smaller than the braces, and only slightly smaller in diameter than the washer here, inner diameter too. Looks like that's 14.8. Bushing looks like it's just over 8 millimeters. This side of the sleeve is 8.52. Bearings are 2 millimeters.